in the early 2000s, we were having to explain to people that open science, open access was a good thing, that we should, things should be open, that a model could be sustainable, that publishing could be quality, it wasn't vanity publishing. There was so much skepticism. So now when we've reached this milestone, I mean, the milestone itself is proof that all of that skepticism was unfounded.
We've been working with the University of California for a really long time, and it was really rewarding to see things come to fruition. I don't think we necessarily had a magic ingredient, but we did have some eureka moments. We clearly were able to share our aims, and the fact that we did share a common goal, which was, you know, enable open science.
So one night I remember quite clearly is when we tried to launch a new version of our sites, and something didn't work. Somewhere at 2 a.m. we found a fix, and suddenly people were dancing in the office. I was behind the camera. You know, we knew that we had it.
So I think for me, the next exciting opportunity is linking all of the aspects of open science together and really increase the impact of the work and the research.
We want to be for our authors and our customers to be really fast and convenient and to be there for them. So everything that we do is really putting kind of the author, the institution, the funders at the heart of what we do. And it's a really exciting time to be in technology and to see it grow and develop.
We've done so much in Europe, and it's very exciting to me to see OA really expand to other regions. And that's ultimately how we're going to get to a full transition once OA's gone truly global. Open access is a business model. It was never meant to be the end point. So what happens next, and how open science can really be built on an open access industry, is really exciting.
Always thinking about what else can we do to help spread scientific research.